crazy. Like, I have so much positive energy flowing through my body right now. It's like, I feel 100% good. Like, really 100% good. Like, every cell of my body right now just feels perfect. I mean, I don't even really believe in perfection, but this is as close as you can possibly come. This is what everybody ultimately wants out of life. Like, everybody's got, you know, different ways to get here, different ways that they think they might get here. But right here, here and now, I'm there. I'm where everybody wants to be. Like, at the deepest level, at the core. Like, things are actually as close as they can come to perfection.
Say the thing about every cell.
Huh?
Every cell in your body.
I just have energy. Energy flowing through my body right now. I feel like all my cells, like, I feel like this higher sense of awareness. And I feel like every cell in my body is just kind of at peace. You know, it's very just calm. Like, I don't feel like any pockets of stress anywhere in my body. Like, I don't feel any negative vibes, any negative energy. It's just this positive energy flowing through all my cells. It's a good feeling.
Look right in the camera. What was the longest you ever ate a pussy? Zoom out to your toe. Emotional,
yeah,
facial.
Cheese doesn't get the brain working. It doesn't produce a lasting effect, or it doesn't have emotional backing behind. And curling of the lips.
Left the tripod.
Kite-surfing.
Say that again.
I like kite-surfing.
What'd you do today?
I flew like a bird. Man has always wanted to fly. Who was it? Icarus? Icarus built wings out of wax, flew too close to the sun. He had the Wright brothers and various others. People have always wanted to fly. I flew today.
Where did you fly?
14.
Boca de Rio Juagaripi.
Juagaripi.
Who with?
With Mike, with David, with the Swiss guy.
That's cool. What about the...
And the Danish dog sled team was practicing their body dragging.
Say we met these dog sledders.
Yeah, we met these guys in the Danish military, and they were stationed in Greenland for 2 years, and they were on dog sled patrol, and they spent all this time out in little tents in negative 57 degree temperature, and they loved their dogs very, very much.
And tell them about the green pill and the blue pill.
So we got them into kite surfing.
They're taking lessons?
They're taking lessons now, yeah. We convinced them that they really should take lessons. And it's probably going to change their life. I think, you know, for the better. But, you know, it is kind of dangerous because once you start kite surfing, you know, you might just want to drop everything and just go kite surf. I know several people who have done this. And, yeah, so I warned them of the risk, you know, because they were asking, like, if it was dangerous. And I told them that was the biggest danger. And I told them that, and then they started asking about the cost, and I told them it's very expensive. You know, you're going to spend a couple thousand dollars on equipment, probably, if you really get into it. So, you know, I warned them of that, and then, but, you know, we were going to go talk to David, you know, to set up some lessons for them.
And they weren't sure if they wanted to take them.
Yeah, like, you know, they were asking me about these risks and stuff, so, you know, we just stopped in the middle of the road, and I said, all right, here's the line, you know, if we go further, you know, you guys are going to turn into kite surfers, and
no,
you guys are going to get hooked. And and I said, it's kind of like that point. Have you guys seen the movie The Matrix? And they had seen The Matrix. And it's kind of like that point where Morpheus asks Keanu Reeves if you know, if he wants to take the red pill or the blue pill. Now I can't remember which one's which, but the point is, it's like, do you guys want to take the red pill and continue? And become kite surfers and maybe get addicted and drop everything else in your life? Or, you know, do you guys just want to turn back now? And stood there for about a second, and they're like, let's go on, let's go on. So they were out body dragging today. And
what's body dragging?
Body dragging is it's when you first get started with the kite, and it pretty much is what it sounds like. You're strapped into the kite, and you don't have a board. You just drag yourself through the water with the kite. It's a lot of fun. Got me hooked, you know. As soon as I felt the power of that kite when I first went body dragging, I just needed more. Like, you know, I just realized like how cool it was going to be once I had that power. And I was on a board, I was planing across the water, and I could stroke the kite like that and just go ripping across the water. Like, I was addicted, I was hooked, I wanted more. And that just continues. Like, the more you kite surf, the more you want. Like, you know, you start body dragging, it's great. It's really exciting, it's thrilling. Then, you know, you start working with the board, and it's frustrating at first, but you want it so bad because you see these guys around you that are just ripping around flying. On the fourth. They're just flying, and you know, you see that, and you're like, you know, you go through the frustration, you fight through it, and then when you first start riding on the board, you know, it's just so exciting to be up on that board. You're just getting pulled across the water, but you're going straight downwind at that point. So
tell us about Esmeralda.
Esmeralda is Mike's love, Mike's only love. Mike refuses to believe in love. Like he thinks love is a big fiction, you know, that it's just like a load of bullshit. But I know Mike has a love in his life.
But just say that
his love is Esmeralda.
What is Esmeralda?
A beautiful kite. Beautiful blue kite. Cabrina.
When did Mike realize he loved Esmeralda?
It was in Cabarete after I had left already, actually.
Dominican Republic.
In the Dominican Republic. It seems like everything happened after I left. But anyway, that's when Mike really fell in love with Esmeralda.
When he was brushing the sand off of Esmeralda at the end of the day at the kite, and he slowed down and realized that he really liked this kite, and maybe even loved it, because it was flying him in the air like wings.
See, man and his kite is like, it's like a teamwork thing. It's like a couple. It's like a love relationship. You know, you try to treat your kite well, and your kite treats you well in return. You know, and sometimes you go through difficult phases. You go through stumbling blocks. You know, like every relationship has to overcome certain hardships, and it's how you overcome these hardships that really determines the strength of the relationship.
What happened yesterday?
Just yesterday, my bar broke.
Your rope.
Like the rope on the bar that connects to the front lines broke, so the kite just completely, you know, popped into the air, depowered, and you know, and my kite got dragged through the water, and you know, got kind of bent up a little bit, and it, you know, it was a rough experience for both of us, but we made it, you know, and today, like the strength of our relationship showed when we had a great session this
How
morning.
How far out did you go?
Yesterday,
Mike and you went out.
We went way out to the reef. Like there's some great little waves out there.
How would you describe this whole location?
This is the best kite spot that I've ever seen. Like this is just amazingly beautiful. Like ridiculously, the water is so just perfectly clean and perfectly blue, and the sand is so white. The rocks are pink and red, and you know, amazing, all sorts of amazing shades. And to have all that together in a spot that's relatively untouched. I mean, there's not too many kiters out there. And the wind, of course. Like the wind today was just so smooth and steady. Like there were hardly any gusts. It was just like a constant flow of perfect power. Yeah, this spot was this spot's pretty close to perfect. Right now, I can't imagine much better than this.
Is that me again? Make it slow, slow. Watch the. Just do all of the poses. Think of the sun too, the angle of the sun. Go ahead.
All right.
Next.
All right.
That hurts?
No. I'm having trouble doing that. I'm not a good model. Like, people are watching me. Like, this is weird, man.
Well, just do the next pose. Did you ever do a contest? Do the one with the arms up in the air, like that one you're doing.
This one?
Yeah, that's good. Do that. Do the bird one.
What's the bird one?
With your arms out like Jesus on the cross. With your hands up in the air.
Like this?
Yeah, lean back. And then bring them forward too, like. Yeah.
Like
and then,
this?
Yeah, and then put your hands on your sides and your hips. And then that one, like this. Lean, tighten it forward. And then the back, do the twist with the back.
I don't know that one.
Yeah. Twist a little bit more toward me. More. And then the back shot.
Oh god. Like with the back shot. Like this?
Yeah, but you have to lean forward so that the sun's on your back. Well, there's two back shots. One, you put your hands in your. You put your hands in your hips and you flare the back muscles out. No, in front. Yeah. And get into them, flow into them, one to the other. Next. Flow into the first one, turn toward me and flow. Flow. Next. Face me and do that one. Yeah, and then the first one, face me. Right. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. The back. Now do them all again because I got the wire in the background. Keep going. Now transition from one to the other to start in the front. Start in the front, yeah. Straight on. Keep going. Next one. Hercules.
You gotta love them to make them grow. That kills me.
Oh god. You're kind of moving on to and out of the picture. I think it's kind of funny, actually.
Yeah, it's good. go out of the light.
There.
Oh. Am I getting close enough? Zoom in a little tiny bit.
Alright, I'm more zoomed in now. Oh god. Yeah, it's pretty funny.
Zoom out a little bit. Am I going out of the frame?
Yeah, you're out of the frame right now.
How about this? Is that good?
Nice, nice.
I think
this is some great footage, man. This is real. That's hilarious.
This is how I feel about having invented kite surfing, but not having invented it.
Out a bit. Okay. Hold on. Can you do that one more time?
Oh yeah, get the just the feet.
Oh, just the feet?
No, you were right.
Okay, this is... Come back one more time and do it?
Yeah.
Good.
Ship, a rocket. Come a little closer so it's always in the light. Okay, so it's out of the picture, you just got blue sky.
Blue sky.
Again. One more. How about this one? Looks like Star Trek. Maybe. How's those look? Like this. Does it look cool?
Yeah.
I have good instincts on what things look good. This might be a good transition, just like weird things flowing in front of the camera. Or straight along. Hypnotize the audience. Or you're just trying to... Okay. Just to meet with that beautiful background, right?
funny?
Yeah.
Am I in the picture now?
No. The problem is that, you know, when I have it zoomed in like this, I don't have your head. But if I get your head, then I get the wires.
Then I walk like this.
Yeah. Hold on. Then I'm gonna have to. Then, okay, I'm gonna point it here now. Okay, this is good. Yeah.
Here?
Yep.
Curiosity about these, the harness. Here, I'll do this. Did that come out?
Yeah. Do that one more time.
Now let's put the harness on again. Ready?
Yeah, it's recording. Trying to minimize that.
Ready?
Yep, it's recording. Yeah.
Alright, let's get this shot perfect so I don't have to do it too many times. You got me?
Oh yeah.
Do you have that in the background and everything good?
Hold on. Oh yeah.
What's gonna happen when I'm down there? You can still see me?
Yep.
Alright, are you recording?
Yep. Good. Good.
Get me. I'm coming out. One more time.
Give us a moonwalk.
I used to be able to do that.
Oh, nice! See if you can do it across. See if you can do it across the entire.
Nice. Can I do it across the tire?
Hold on. Like.
Ready?
Start there. Good.
The other way.
Where were we before?
It was... Yeah, the tide. The tide's higher now. We were right down there, but that part's wet now. So, I guess it's here.
Don't need to, Casey. I get this close up of this unrolling the lines. Look, let me see them. Let me see them. Let me see them.
É muito bom, não tem palavras não, Skate é a melhor coisa que tem pra fazer.
Oh, thank you. I forgot it.
Chips, three chips,
red, green, blue.
Okay.
And then good time.
Tell us about the kite surfing. Your first day of kite surfing.
12 kilometers away.
It was very great.
It was just a completely different experience.
We just went out in the morning, and then it just escalated from the small kites up to the bigger, and all of a sudden we were just being dragged through the water,
smaller,
having no control over it.
Was it like? The dog sled, how?
No, the dog sleds, they behave.
The dogs behave better than the kite?
Yeah, the kite doesn't behave.
But, you know, like,
what's
the water
the kite's like
really
what?
Yeah, the kite's, yeah.
Swells that don't really
play. I don't know, it's very rebellious, but you just have to squeeze it a little bit and nurse it a bit, and then it's quite good.
Yeah. That's cool.
Yeah.
Are you happy that you did it?
No, yeah, very happy.
Your first day of kiting.
Yeah, we're not gonna. I'm not regret it, and I probably should buy a kite one day.
Yeah. Oh, I have many.
Yeah.
I have a kite for sale.
Yeah.
Let me see.
Actually, when I was in Denmark, I thought I'd just buy a small kite, you know. There's a lot of people just going out with a kite, small, just like the children's, just a little bit bigger, and they're just playing around with them. So I was thinking on buying it, but now go bigger.
Get some real stuff.
Yeah.
You know what a foil is?
A foil?
It's a kite, but it doesn't inflate. It's just.
That's what we played in the morning.
Yeah.
First thing we did, we call it stun kite.
The little kite. You can get a big one. So when you're in the snow, if you put it down, it just collapses.
Yeah, that's right.
Peter Lin kite.
Yeah, I have seen it before.
I saw
There's
some people
really
have
much wind.
Some are riding those.
Yeah, but, you know, it's still kind of... No, it's matter of liking or not liking. I don't like
Whatever.
There's one guy in San Diego that rides them all the time.
Yeah.
But
he says that they're better for light wind, or he just
the new Cabrinas, they're I think a lot more popular now.
Like the crossbow.
Wow, two different ones.
Which?
The switchblade.
The switchblade.
Cabrina, kind of something like the crossbow, just
see the technology just moves too
tuned,
fast.
I think they said.
I gotta sit back, give it a year. Wait till they perfect their systems. Yeah,
the best guy.
Yeah,
I'd give it 2 years. Man.
2 years. Is that there's different steps in the learning process. You know, first you just go out and you body drag and like you experience the power of the kite, all this power. You know, you body drag and you take the kite through the power zone and it pulls you through the water and it's just so exciting. You realize like how much power you're able to harness. Then you get up on the board, you know, and all of a sudden you're just planing across the water. And you're just totally excited because you're riding.
You crash the kite.
There's a lot of difficulties along the way. You'll make 100 mistakes. You're gonna make 100 mistakes. You're gonna be scared at times, whatever. But every step, you know, then you get to the point where you're able to stay upwind and you can ride back and forth to the same spot all day, and then you can get to a spot upwind to the point you started. And then all of a sudden it's like
you can go anywhere you want.
You can go anywhere you want, and that opens up all sorts of possibilities. You can jump, you can go out, you can ride waves, you can ride anywhere you want and just come back to your starting point. And then you never have to walk up the beach. You can just ride all day.
Oh.
And then you start riding waves. You know, yeah. Oh, this is so cool. You know, I'm able to surf all day. I don't have to paddle. Then you start jumping, you know, and you're just flying. You're like, this is the coolest thing ever. Yeah. I mean, every step you get, you know, it just gets more and more fun. You guys are only at the beginning. This like snowball effect of fun.
Snowboarding,
kiting.
Snowboarding, the kiting.
Yeah.
A lot of snowballers.
It helps. You know,
then you don't need to fight the board that much because you already know a little bit what it does.
Yeah.
It's all from
wakeboarding.
Wakeboarding. I do only a little bit of rail. That's fun too. You just edge in and let go board.
So what is
and you
take
it without.
We bring all the stuff here.
Shifting kite.
Where have you done rail? North Carolina?
Just going to cut the cheese, they said.
Rail.
A lot of cheese then.
This movement.
Yeah,
this jump.
Just go.
Edge hard.
Okay, but maybe we eat for
tomorrow. Call it down. Edge hard.
Love you, bud.
Then let go board. Basically on the back tip.
I thought you said rails. You know, slide on the rails.
No. Look at that. Look at
that.
The red light went on. What does that mean?
I know, I gotta put a tape over that red light so people don't know when they're getting filmed.
That's better, actually.
I was kiting down in Natal, right? And so this assistant, he's a Brazilian guy, and you know, salaries are really low here. So his win is to, he gets, you know, you give him a few dollars of 10 reais a day to get your kite up, put the lines out, do everything, catch you, watch you. If there's a problem, he comes out in a boat. So he gets his money by getting you up in the air. So he's like, there's this huge storm clouds, giant black clouds coming from the horizon, right? And he's opening my kite, pumping it up, putting the lines out. And I'm like, I don't think I should go out. You know, the first thing my teacher taught me is never go out if there's black clouds where the wind is coming from. Because that means a storm and that means gusts and everything. So I said, I don't think I should go. He goes, if there's a problem, he said, just come back and, you know. he's making his money by getting me out there, you know. So he wanted me
and
to get
And saving
up.
You.
Yeah, I was on a 10, totally sheeted in, completely sheeted in. And I start kiting and it's really overpowered. And then a gust came and I lost my board. So I'm body dragging back to the board. Just then this 40 kilometer or 40 knot wind just came right out of those black clouds. And it was like, I was flying body dragging faster than wind. I mean, only my feet were touching. And then I said, I turned, I went back to the board. And then as I was turning to go back to the board, I put it up at the top. Well, then another 40 knot, and I flew straight up in the air, went like 30 meters downwind, went back in, and the next gust took me up, and so I was like, so then luckily I just turned the board, you know, the kite, and went in.
You got the board too.
Well, then we had to go find the board. Okay. So I was going to swim out to this jangada, which it looks like it's really close, right? But when it's just pouring rain by this time. And the wind's 40 knots and there's huge waves. So, like, I was like, I'm gonna swim to the boat, the jangada that's anchored, and I'm gonna stand up there and I'm gonna look out and find the board. Well, meanwhile, he goes and gets a boogie board and he's gonna swim and try to find the board. So I start swimming out, and I realize that in those big waves and the wind, it's a lot farther. The jangada, and it was like, wow, it was scary. But I finally got to the jangada, and I'm holding on. And then I climb up, and I'm standing up, and then I end up just lying there with the rain pounding down, and saying, "What the fuck am I doing?" Anyway, don't ever go out if there's black clouds on the horizon. If you see any black clouds, that means big gusts.
Unless you're in Cabarete.
Oh, in Cabarete, every single day we went black out in front of the black clouds. Yeah, it was totally normal.
Otherwise, you don't
yeah.
go.
Otherwise, because yeah. of this El Nino effect, there's no wind in Cabarete. So the only way you got wind was when these storms were coming in. So there would be huge billowing clouds, black
and everybody
clouds
would be excited. And then, but the wind stops. When the black clouds reach the beach, you know. But if they're 50 meters away from the beach, then you're gonna get great wind for a little while, and you can do big jumps. Like, how do you know if like the clouds really, at the beach, or you know whether?
Well, this one time, this huge storm was coming, right? And there's this guy named Charlie. Charlie is like the spirit of kite surfing. He's this little skinny guy. He's Swiss.
Local.
He's actually Swiss. He's Swiss. And two or three years ago, he was doing his lines, and he handed his lines to someone to hold while he did something at the bar. And then he went back. He was totally, totally addicted to kite surfing. That's all he wanted to do. And he went back to the guy, and he said, "Are these the same as I gave them to?" And he's, you know, and he said, "Yes, they're the same." So he put them on the kite. If you put the lines opposite as they're supposed to be, and you launch the kite, it'll start looping and you will not be able to control. So he put the lines on backwards. The kite started looping. He flew up over the buildings on the beach, over the highway, and smashed his head into a brick wall. And it took them 3 hours to decide to take him to the hospital. Does he have insurance? Does he not have insurance? Oh. Da, da, da. So anyway, then
in Cabarete?
Yeah. They took him to the hospital, and they operated. He had a hematoma, a cracked skull, and they said that 95% of the people that get this die, and 5% are vegetables. But he's still kiting.
Okay. No problem though.
No problem. But he's totally.
But he's a little crazy.
Oh,
he's a little
crazy.
He probably was already crazy,
but because I didn't know him before.
Yeah,
but
no.
No, so, just like,
so wait. So one day there's this huge storm coming in, black clouds, and everyone's kiting and kiting. And they have this big horn. There's 50 kiters out.
Yeah,
it's
horn
so
means
crowded.
Get off the water.
I mean, there's four kiters coming in, and there's three kiters going out, and your lines are just. Mm. I mean, it's so crazy. It's so close. So, what happens is, the horn blows, and everyone comes in because that's the storm is coming. Everyone has to come in. So it just starts pouring rain, and you can't see anything. It's all white, misty. We're all on the beach under the thing. 30 minutes later, Charlie comes out of the mist to the beach with his iPod earphones
on. He always has music. He's always just like.
And he has a board that's this big with no foot straps. And he rides it with no foot straps. He's amazing. He's just the best.
How can you with no foot straps when you
go
up in the air?
No one knows. No one has figured it out.
Okay. He rides with a pulley bar with no deep power, you know. So like, you know, like your kites, you know, you were able to power or depower based on where you hold the bar, you know, and then you can make other adjustments. He just has the same constant level of power always, you know, and he's just got it hooked into his harness with full power, and his depower is purely in his feet, purely in his position on the board. You know, if he puts more weight on his board, or whether he rides more on his edge, and you know what board he takes out, his depower is purely in terms of like just you know where he puts the kite in the sky, and you know.
He sounds more like a legend.
Yeah, Charlie's
a legend. He's a legend. That's exactly right.
Okay.
Cool.
Do you know this guy with one leg there?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. He's cool.
He's kiting.
Yeah, he's amazing. He rides with no... There's a... In Cabarete, there's a guy...
But he doesn't stay on the board.
He stands on the board with one leg.
I've seen him stand on the board.
I've seen him stand on the board many times. He stands on the board.
Normally he just kind of puts his leg on there. There's no straps or anything. You know, he just kind of puts his leg on there, and he goes out, and he's really, really good. He's got amazing kite control. Like, I mean, he always knows where the kite is. Like, he's able to do all sorts of amazing things with the kite, and he's able to stay on this board. You know, and he's jumping off little waves and just kind of like holding on to the board. And you know, I've never seen the guy get separated from his board. But yeah, I've also seen him stand up with his one leg, ride strapless on the board.
It's a big surfboard.
Yeah.
All right. There you go. One more.
This one's
good.
Great
chip. It's good?
Yours?
Yeah. Nice.
How many
people?
Yeah, right.
I don't know.
No, but the place.
Yeah.
I mean, we have enough, huh?
Not really. Well, for everyone here, but what about you and Daniel?
Daniel, oh, look, we have this one. Somebody.
Oh, right.
Yeah,
and Mike. Yeah. Yeah. Over here. There's more, but. Yo.
How's the food?
Delicious.
Wind. Howling. Morning.
Breakfast?
Yeah. Dude, I swear to God, this is the coolest thing I've ever seen on video. I'm shooting it. Dude, I am so talented. Do you ever go to those films like in Boulder at the local, you know, art theaters? But you've gone.
I didn't really start watching it. I mean, yeah, I've gone, but like, I didn't really start watching like.
Oh, but then you did it in New York?
Yeah, a little bit, yeah.
So you know what I'm talking about.
Huh?
You know what I'm talking about.